Are we allowed the nikah where, like in India, we have the concept of mixed gatherings, dance and music and all as the functions before the nikah? So as their immediate relatives, are we allowed to attend all those functions?
My sister, if the function of nikah, as you know, is a sacred function, and if there is something haram happening there, then you can excuse yourself. I have done it so many times. I've excused myself from functions because I felt that it would damage my own level. Perhaps I may be going there and I don't want to be bumping into, you know, women, or to bumping into things that are terrible and bad. You know, alcohol is being drunk there, and sometimes music is being blasted in the ears. You know, if you're walking through a mall and you have something to do in the mall, or you're walking through a place and someone's blasting the music and so on, it's one of those things. But for us to go and attend a function where a lot of haram is happening, it's actually our right and our freedom not to go. You know, just like sometimes if you were to invite the Hindus to your home, you need to be conscious of what they believe as well. So don't insult them by putting things that will actually be insulting to them on the table, and so on. You need to respect what they believe with disagreement. You might disagree, they disagree, but you respect that they are allowed to do what they're doing, and so are you. So the same would apply to other Muslims. Sometimes if they're doing something that we believe is unacceptable, then they should understand that, look, this is unacceptable, but say it in a beautiful way. The problem with us sometimes, and I'm not saying yourself, I'm saying perhaps even myself at a certain stage, and maybe a lot of us would benefit from this little piece that I'm about to say. The problem is, when we turn to religion a little bit, we become a bit aggressive. And we think that, you know what, the way I talk to someone is such that I'm holier than you, and that's it. I'm not coming. There's haram happening in that function. Relax. There's a way of talking. Say, no, mashallah, I'd love to come. Here's a gift. You know, go to them a day ahead, their family. Go and spend a little bit of time. Go and give them your gift and thank them. Make a lot of dua. And, you know, say something to them. You know, I may not be able to attend, but, you know, that's it. I'll try my best. But X, Y, and Z. I recall a function that I was invited to, and I was told clearly that this function is completely separated. You see, if they tell you in advance what's going on, it's one of those things. And when I got there, I saw it totally mixed. So on grounds of principle of being lied to, I actually told him, Salaamu Alaikum, and I'm departing. And I departed. And I told the brother who had invited me, look, my brother, I love you so much. I pray for you. Allah grant you success. And I hope, I wish all the best for you. But you know what? You actually deceived me. You told me that it's not going to be like this, and it is like this. He said, no, but you know this and you know that. And I said, look, my brother, I'm not saying it because I don't like you. I love you. But I won't be able to be there. And the reality is, you should have told me in advance. You made me travel all the way. You made me come all the way here. And this is what I found. So this, I'm just telling you, I've done it. And whether people like you for that or not is one of those things. It's one of those things. And there have been times when you have to, sometimes you're caught in a certain spot where you may have to greet someone of the opposite sex. You may have to interact with them, but that interaction should be limited to whatever is necessary. And, you know, it shouldn't go into that which is flirting and so on and so forth. May Allah protect us all. We're living in a world where, yes, we're going through a lot of difficulty. I've interacted with so many females, whether it's in the bank or the aircraft or anywhere else, sometimes on the street, sometimes passing in a passage and so on, and people greet you. It's our right to actually greet back. Subhanallah, you have to. And sometimes you have to greet because, you know what, you are the Muslim that's there. I've known of cases where women have been stuck with their motor vehicles on the roads, and I have actually stopped in order to help and assist, and they were just women and me, and that was it. And I felt that it's better that I stop and assist these Muslim women than someone whom we don't know stops and assist them. Subhanallah. And you do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the point I'm raising is, as we get closer to Allah, let's not let it affect our character negatively. When we talk to others, be calm with them. Try and explain to them. It took us 20 years sometimes to see the light. It might take them 40 years. We can't expect them to come in 5 minutes, 10 minutes. If you don't see the light, that's it, you're astray. Make dua and keep on trying. Jazakumullah khair.
Jazakumullah khair. Please make dua for my
sons. May Allah bless you and bless us all.
Muhammad Anas and Muhammad Hamza.
Ameen. Barakallah fiqh. Allah bless them and bless us all and all our children. And those who don't have children, may Allah grant you children who will be the coolness of your eyes. And those who are not married yet, may Allah grant you spouses who will be the coolness of your eyes.
Ameen.
Ameen. Wow, I heard that quite loud. Masha'Allah. Alhamdulillah. Ameen.